You're back. This is Mommy and Me. I'm Mandy. We're on week 29 of our pregnancy journey. This is our check-in for a fit pregnancy. I'm Mandy.
I'm Dan.
Subscribe to
Buzz Chomp.
Woo! Talked before about having a fit pregnancy and how I did my first time around, and that was my plan for the second time. So this is our check-in. I'll share with you where I'm at, and then I'll give you some tips now being in our third trimester. For me, I've definitely adjusted my workouts. That's fine. That's totally fine, guys. It's totally fine. And I told you that that would be a lot. I really love to run. So for me, running, pushing the stroller, sometimes I just have to run less miles, and that's fine. I'll make up my miles later in the year. I also, you know, been trying to change up my routes. I've been going out for runs by myself more and more because it is harder to push the stroller, and I do go faster without pushing a, you know, 30 something pound child. That is making it even more difficult. Last time around, I didn't have a baby to push. I didn't have a child to push. It was just me and my bump, and I thought it was hard then. So now it's like just making sure that I'm okay. I got a little sick at the beginning of this year. I thought I would be okay. Maddie and Dan had a cold, so I had to take 2 days off from running, and it's fine. I wanted to not take 2 days off from running, but I reminded myself that that's part of me being on this fit journey and realizing, okay, you need to take a step back. You need to relax. Same thing around the holidays. It was really, really cold. There were days that I just couldn't go outside and run in that cold. So I brought it in. I did some indoor workouts and all of that. I'll probably be adding more of the elliptical in if it gets rainy here in Los Angeles, or if I'm just really sore and I need to take it easy, I'm going to do the elliptical instead. So that's like where I'm at right now. Also, I'm still doing my 30-day challenges, but I'm just making sure that I don't do ones with like a lot of core work in the sense of like traditional abs. I've done some circuits, and I think I'm going to be adding in a little bit more circuits too, as especially if it gets more difficult to run. So that's where I am at. So for you, first off, if you're on a fit pregnancy journey like I am, do not listen to anyone else. I'm telling you, unless it's your doctor, listen to your doctor, ladies. Don't listen to people when they say to you, oh, you're still running, you're still working out, you really shouldn't do that, you really shouldn't do that. I need to stress it because you need to do you. And if you're like me and working out is a big essential part of who you are and a part of your daily process, then that's fine. As long as you're doing it in a healthy way, as long as you've consulted your doctor and your doctor knows, there's no reason why you can't continue on. Anyone tells you not to doesn't know you and doesn't know your body, and you know your body. As long as you're not ignoring some pain, as long as you're not ignoring your body, because your body will catch up to you, especially when you're pregnant. Invest in a foam roller. I love my foam roller. Sometimes I'll be like, oh, I don't need to do my foam roller after I run, and I'm like regretting it later and doing it later because I'm like, oh no, should have definitely done my foam roller. You have a lot going on inside of your body with the growing baby. There's a lot more pressure. So third trimester, your back is gonna hurt because you have extra weight and it's all settled in this one area too. Invest in a foam roller, get one on Amazon. I'll recommend one in my Buzz Chomp post. It's super awesome. They're amazing, and you'll feel like so great after doing it. It really works out the kinks. It really stretches you out, and it's amazing, and I love it. Drink a lot of water. I have to constantly remind myself. I always think I'm drinking a lot of water, but drink a lot of water. Need that water when you're pregnant. You need that water when you work out. So drink a lot of water. I always say this one because I think it's totally and completely true, but just remember to have fun. Pregnancy is not my favorite time of my life. I love the result, but it's a lot on my body to have a baby. It's a lot of pressure and all of that. So just have fun when you go and run. Like the 2 days that I didn't run, I was like craving to run, but I knew that I needed to relax my body and shake the cold. I'm having fun. Like when I got back out and ran, I had so much fun. When I ran by myself, I had so much fun. I was craving, and I love that. So whatever you do, just have fun, ladies. Having a fit pregnancy is amazing. It's going to help you deliver. It's going to help you get your pre-pregnancy body back, whatever that is for you, whatever that means to you. Really, what it's going to help you do is shed your body weight. So after your pregnancy, people are going to look at you and be like, oh, you just had a baby. Because that's what happened to me before. They were like, You just had a baby? Really? Really? And it just goes to show like how much your body is, how your body is resilient and how it can do so much stuff and how us women, we are so strong. We can give birth. We can do anything. You don't have to call yourself unless you're having a high risk pregnancy, of course. If you're having just a normal pregnancy, keep on it. Keep doing what you're doing. Have fun doing it. And share with me your details of your journey. I'm Mandy. Subscribe to Mommy and Me for more of our pregnancy journey. And comment below, what are you doing to stay on your fit pregnancy journey? Yeah, kids. Yeah. Thanks for watching Buzz Chomp.
Subscribe and share.
Subscribe and share.
Subscribe and share.
Woo.